gentlemen, boys and girls, this is Jeremy Meyer, and you are watching Hollywood Unwrapped on Examiner.com, coming to you from a day of champions brought to you by Yahoo Sports. We're here at the Los Angeles Sports Museum, which is one of the biggest sports memorabilia museums that is privately owned. Right behind me, we have Ashley Force's drag racing car. In today's edition, we're going to talk to John Force, Brittany Force, Matt Kemp from the Dodgers, and so many more. So stay tuned right here. First of all, thank you so much for coming out for a day of the champions. Do you have a special cause that matters to you?
A special cause that matters to me. I mean, really, for me, it's about connecting with these kids and touching the lives of them and showing them all the different things that they can do and what sports can do for them. And having this facility just makes it really easy because they get to see all the cool things that happens when you can actually devote your life to something like a sport like volleyball for me. Yeah. Really, the difference between beach and indoor is huge. They're completely different sports. Yes, it's volleyball. Fundamentals are very similar. Yeah, so indoor is 6 players, beach volleyball is 2 players. Obviously with beach we have all the different elements, so like wind, we have the water, we have the sand, we have the sun. And so it's a lot more about strategy and control, whereas you get to the 6 people and you're indoor and it's a lot more power and strength and aggression. So they are very, very different.
Well, and being that you went from indoor to beach, you've been all over the planet now, haven't you? Tell us a little bit more about that.
Thanks to volleyball, I have traveled to 28 different countries. Yes, I'm very, very fortunate. I've lived in Moscow, I've lived in Cyprus, I've lived in Korea, and varying anywhere from 3 weeks to 8 months. So I've gotten to go to some really, really cool places.
With beach volleyball, do you play in a league or is it just tournament style?
Well, for indoor and beach, it's very different. So, like, we have the NBA here, we have the NFL, all those the organized sports. It's the same over in Europe. So every country will have a league of 8 to 14 teams, and then they are allotted a certain number of foreigners. So, for example, Korea is 1 foreigner, Greece is 2, Puerto Rico is 3. And so you go over and you participate in those teams. So, for example, in Russia, I was the only American on the team, and the only other foreigner was Croatian, and everyone else is Russian. So you have to learn the language, you kind of have to learn the culture. But for beach, it's more just 2 girls, it's an American, you're here in the country, and there's tournaments. So it's not so much like the structured, for example, the NBA or the NFL. It's not similar to that. So yeah.
No, because we've seen and read there's like National Women's Volleyball League, like supposedly being founded.
Yes, we actually have 5 different tours right now, and they're all for beach. We have the USA Tour, which is sponsored by Cuervo, the best. Not to drink, I'm just saying. The organization.
Well, Cuervo ain't too bad either.
I'm not complaining. But we also have the NVL, which is the National Volleyball League. We have, Corona Light. We have CBVA, and the AVP is actually coming back. It's making a comeback, so yeah.
Being that we're at a children's event, the steps on being where we are today as a pro volleyball player.
The steps, I mean, really, you're going to come down to the basic fundamentals of what it takes to be great at what it is you do. You talk to any professional athlete and it's about dedication and hard work and really being passionate and loving what it is you're doing, because you're not going to keep going unless you wake up every day wanting to do what you're doing. So I would wake up every day and I would want to practice. I would go to practice early. I would leave practice late. And everyone I surrounded myself with were people who were great at what they did. I got a chance to train next to Troy Polamalu at 16 years old and see him, like the dedication, the hard work that he put into it and what it took. So I got to see what it took to be great. So, yeah.
So you played in high school, college, and then pro?
I started actually club when I was 13. I graduated from San Clemente High School, played there, and then I played at UC Berkeley, and I've been on the U.S. national team for 5 years now for indoor, but I actually just switched to beach, which I'm excited about, and made the U.S. national team there as well. So it's definitely a progression from club, high school, college, and then you go pro.
But you are the image for all the high school volleyball players that you can play volleyball for a living.
Oh, you definitely can, and I love that. Like, I want to be able to touch those lives and meet those girls and encourage them to keep going, because it's such a fantastic sport and it's such a great way to live your life. I've gotten to see so many different things and so many different cultures and, I mean, beautiful places and meet incredible people just from being able to play volleyball. And so definitely, I want to encourage all those kids to just keep doing what they're doing, especially if they love it.
Where can we see you next?
Next? Well, we just finished our season on the beach, so the next season will be starting up in March. We are always in Manhattan Beach, Hermosa Beach, all up and down the coast practicing, so if you ever want to come and watch or encourage us, I mean, we always love having fans come by and say hi. So next time you'll see us actually competing will be in March.
Yeah. So we can follow you on Twitter and Facebook to get locations?
Yeah. Morgan E. Beck on Twitter, and morganebeck.com is my website, so definitely come check it out.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure.
Really nice meeting you.
The pleasure was all mine.